Hello everyone, thank you for tuning in tonight to our third virtual concert. My name is Julia Tai.
And I'm Jeremy Jolly.
And we are the co-artistic directors of Seattle Modern Orchestra. We hope these virtual concerts have lifted your spirits during these challenging times. We believe that we need art now more than ever, and even though we can't physically be together, we can still be connected with each other through music. I have been thinking about how composers have persevered and never stopped composing, even during some of the most difficult times in history. A prime example is Olivier Messiaen's Quartet for the End of Time, which he wrote while being a prisoner of war in a German camp during World War II. He wrote music for his fellow prisoner musicians and premiered the piece at the camp in front of an audience of other prisoners and guards. I hope this music give all of us hope, and we will persevere and get through this together.
Yes, creativity and human expression never stops. And we are happy to share with you two works by Seattle composers tonight. The world premiere of Greg Dixon's Mirror Lake 2 for clarinet and electronics, a meditative journey on a life lived, youth, aging, memory, and death. To close the program, and straight from our SMO archives, is our US premiere performance of Huck Hodge, Alethea for Ensemble. This work explores two ancient and opposite definitions of truth. On the one hand, truth is a fixed and unchanging reality. On the other, truth is a constant flux. Both works speak to our complex and uncertain experience, how we navigate through our current lives with listening and reflection, and choices we must make in the search of truth.
I hope you enjoy the music tonight. And if you like our performance, please consider donating to SMO to help cover the cost of virtual concert productions. Your donation will support our musicians and help Seattle Modern Orchestra stay strong as an organization and carry out our mission in a brighter future when we can produce live concerts again.
Thank you for joining us. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Rachel Yoder, and thanks for tuning in to the Seattle Modern Orchestra's virtual concerts. Tonight, I'm excited to share with you the premiere of a piece called Mirror Lake 2 by Greg Dixon. This premiere was originally planned for a conference in March, but with the events of the pandemic, we decided to create a video here in our home studio where we are isolated with our family. And we are excited that SMO is bringing that performance to you tonight. Greg and I perform together in a clarinet and electronics duo that we call Odd Partials, specializing in improvisation and performance of interactive works in which both players take an active role. I want to give you some insight into what you're about to hear. Mirror Lake 2 is an open form piece inspired by a poem called A History of the Sketch by Richard Hugo. And the poem has imagery of an old man sitting next to a lake reflecting on his life and memories. So the piece has four main sections, and you'll see that I begin on bass clarinet and find my way through the score, recalling youth on the E-flat clarinet, middle age on the B-flat soprano clarinet, and then ending back on bass clarinet. The musical material within the sections consists of short melodies which recall imagery from the poem. So these are presented forwards, backwards, and in inversion in the score, allowing me to choose which phrase I play and which manipulation or reflection of the phrase that I'm going to play at any given moment. Greg acts as a sort of subconscious. So he's adding effects onto my clarinet sound and recording phrases, manipulating them, and replaying them at various moments throughout the piece. And this is all done with a patch using the Max MSP software. Throughout the piece, Greg and I constantly reflect on what we are hearing and the associations of the poem in order to decide what to do next. Each performance is unique, and we never know exactly what will happen, but we hope that you enjoy this rendition of Mirror Lake 2.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello, my name is Huck Hodge, and I'd like to introduce my piece, Aletheia, from 2011. It was performed and recorded by the Seattle Modern Orchestra in autumn of 2014. Just a couple words about the piece. The title refers to different conceptions of the underlying reality of the universe in pre-Socratic philosophy. The two ideas basically being that whatever is true is unchanging. It's an idea attributed to Parmenides. And the opposite of that was another powerful idea, namely that everything in the universe changes. That's an idea attributed to Heraclitus. Heraclitus talks about, for instance, how we never step into the same river twice because it's always in a constant state of flux and motion. And so the piece plays around with different sorts of musical stasis and motion. You could think of that in harmonic terms. For instance, the opening of the piece is based on a single chord that lasts almost a minute. And at various other points in the piece, the harmonies, the harmonic rhythm moves more and more rapidly, accelerates or decelerates, so that you get a sense of temporal flow. The same could be said about timbre. Sometimes the timbres are fixed, you know, just sort of the straightforward timbres, the standard timbres of the instruments. And then at other points, the timbres change constantly, modulate. There's a lot of crossfading between different instruments and so on. All right, well, I hope you enjoy the piece.
Thank you.